What's going on, you guys? BTIC back again, bringing you guys a brand new video, and today is something pretty special. So anyone that's been on Twitter or YouTube knows that Sun and Moon just came out. So a buddy of mine picked me up after work, and we ended up going to the store and picking up a few packs. Well, I ended up going a little bit bigger. I did pick up an Elite Trainer box for Sun and Moon. So I haven't opened up an Elite Trainer in a while, but it looks like it comes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... 8 packs, sleeves, dividers, a few dice, damage counters, energies, a booklet, anything else? 2 acrylic condition mark. Oh, yes, yeah, so that's condition markers. The box itself can hold the whole collection. And it looks like it... I could have sworn these came with 10 packs before, but I could be wrong. Like I said, I haven't opened these up in a while. So let's get straight into this. Ugh. At least the seal came off a little bit easier than usual. Ugh. So there's the booklet. I'm not going to look through it. So I was never really big for like foreign cards. So I never bought Sun and Moon when it was in Japanese. I never really watched any videos for it either because I didn't want to spoil anything. So all the cards are going to be pretty new to me. I mean, I've seen a few cards on Twitter that people post, but I've never actually sat down and went through the list of what cards are going to be in the set. The one thing I do know, it seems like the ultra rares have like 3 stages. So they have like the regular GX card, and there's like a full art that's textured, and then there's like a rainbow card after. And I know now there's hyper rare cards, which is even rarer than a secret rare. So they've just added so much more into this. It's pretty crazy. So for the sealing of the box, let's take a cool look at it. Wherever it is sealed. Sealed on the top. There it is. So if you don't know, the Elite Trainer boxes, the outside, well, the inside rather, has like cool pictures on it. So it looks like it has all the last evolutions of the starters and then the 2 legendaries. So that's pretty cool. That's awesome. So let's get into the goods now. All the cardboard out of the way. So hopefully they gave us all Sun and Moon packs, which they did, so that's cool. There's some Elite Trainers that you get like random packs out of. So we got pack of sleeves. Hopefully we'll be using those. Awesome purple dice. It looks blue on my camera, but it's purple. They're awesome. Then hey guys, you gotta take that code. I didn't know it came with a code. So if you're the lucky one to get that, I wonder what you get. I wonder if you get the whole box, because that'd be pretty sweet. You got the 3-4 dividers. Then we got all the energies. I don't think we gotta go through those. Oh, another pack. And that's it. So we went through all the goodies. Wait, I didn't get damage markers. Huh. What's this? Oh, there they are. What's that GX thing? Okay, I don't know what that is. I think it's just like a cool display looking thing. That's actually pretty cool. Put that in the back. That's awesome. Then we got the damage counters. Okay, so now on to the good stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 packs. So we do have all of them now. We're not missing any. Let's see what we can get. Probably still 3 from the back, if I had to guess. So I wonder where they're going to go, like, competitive-wise. Because, like, I wonder if they, like, reprinted, like, old trainers and supporters that are going to be, like, really good that are going to be rotating out soon. So, I'm pretty curious about that. So, we do have the Alola forms. So, that's pretty cool. So, we have Diglett, Dratini, Sandygast. I've never really played the game that much. I'm honestly, like, an hour in. So, I don't know a lot of the new Pokemon. Morello. Reverse Growlithe. And what a way to start. We have Lurantis GX. Which I believe that's going to be like the first GX card. It's just like the glossy cover to it. Which is weird. I think that's in the reverse spot. I don't know. But that's a great way to start. We have a GX card. And then we have a Metal Energy. Which I think they have reverse energies. I mean, yeah, reverse holo energies. Okay, so I need to open these. Alright, so let's sleeve this up. There we go. So that's a great way to start. That's awesome. Off to a great start. It seems like a lot of people are having like insane pulls. Now for booster boxes, if you have open evolutions, it seemed the pull ratio was up to like 9 ultra rares. That's what I got out of my box. And I'm seeing other people's pulls now for Sun and Moon. And it seems like they're only pulling 8 ultra rares. Like 8 or 7. So they must have went down a little bit. But the cards are wicked sick. So I can see why if they did. Then Metapod. Rattata. Sandile. Pikapek, Sparrow, Formatus, Reverse Wingull, and a... Okay, so I guess you're guaranteed a energy card. Then we have a regular rare Hariyama. So, how do you guys feel about the way, like, the cards look? Because they do have a different, like, look and feel to them. Obviously, it is a new set, so they gotta change it up a little bit. I'm kind of digging it. Like, I don't know. There's always something that you just look and feel weird to me. But a lot of it looks like really like cartoony, acclimated. Like, look on the art. I'm really digging it. It's really cool. So we have Metapod. Team Skullgrunt. Your opponent reveals their hand. Discard 2 energy cards from it. That's sick. That is a great card. Gramble, Poliwag. Now that's a cool Poliwag. That thing, it looks like it's knitted. That's really cool. That's what I'm saying about the way some of these cards are. Eevee. Now Eevee's usually pretty good. When you attach a basic energy card from your hand to this Pokemon during your turn, you may search your deck for a card that evolves from this Pokemon that is the same type as that energy card that you put onto the Pokemon to evolve it. That's pretty great. Now, I wonder if that would count as... Oh, wait, they won't evolve again, so it doesn't matter. I was going to say, I wonder if that counts as evolving for that turn. Obviously, Eevee only evolves once. So, next we have a reverse Bruxish. Kind of... I don't know. It's kind of like an ugly Pokemon, but it's not at the same time. Like, they try to make it really feminine. It's kind of an ugly Pokemon, but it is a reverse rare. So, that's pretty sweet. Then we have a holo Arcanine for our first holo. So that's sick. Arcanine's amazing. He's definitely in my top 5. And then we have a fire energy. So that's awesome. Let me get a sleeve for Arcanine. I wish I had penny sleeves. I still gotta go pick some up. Because I'm not really a fan of just, especially when it comes to like ultra rares, I'm not a fan of just putting them in sleeves. I like to use penny sleeves as well. So, next pack. So far we have a reverse rare, a holo, and a GX out of, what, 4 packs, which isn't bad. You guys can take a code. 1, 2, 3. We have 5 packs, including the one in my hand. What's that? Lima? Each opponent shuffles a hand into their deck and flips a coin. If heads, that player draws 6 cards. If tails, they draw 3. I know there's a card in an earlier set. Ooh, Hypno's really cool. That, like, it's a trainer, and if you have, like, less prize cards than your opponent, then you draw 6 cards and they draw 3, so it's not really a flip. It's kind of a guarantee. So I don't think that card is as strong as the other one, but it's still a chance to change the game. So that's a cool card. Crabominnow, I can't pronounce that. That's pretty cool. That's still another reverse rare. Excuse me. Still another reverse rare, so that's awesome. And then a Masquerain regular rare. Oh, and then we got a Lightning Energy. So, at least getting reverse rares aren't that bad. I mean, I could go for a couple more holos. But reverses aren't that bad. I still count them as a win. 3. And it's unfortunate, when my friend was over, he was going to give me the code cards to put online to open packs. And apparently they're down. How you draw 3 cards? I mean, there's a card that lets you draw 6 cards. Oh no, it is still just 3. Never mind. Never mind. Let's just pretend I didn't say anything. Dungoose, Paris, Caterpie, Makuhita, Chinchou. Chinchou is really cool. I like the evolution of him. Reverse Cosmog, and a Cloyster regular rare with a water energy. At least we get different energies. That's pretty cool. I go for a dark energy. Dark is psychic. Two, 3. So we have a Pelipper, EXP share, Alola Raticate, Pikipek, Sparrow, Fomatis, Morlul, Skarmory, Reverse Bulldoor. Whoops, I almost pronounced them wrong. And a Palo Sand, which is just a sandcastle. That's interesting. And then we have a Psychic Energy. So we have 2 packs left. Hopefully, if I'm lucky, maybe one more Ultra. If not, I would like a couple more Holos. We've been getting quite a few regular rares. These packs just break so easily. 2, 3. We have Bulldoor, Ultra Ball, which is sick. I'm glad they brought that card back, and I guess that is a secret rare. Secret rare or hyper rare, one of the two, but the card looks sick. Pinsir, he looks scary. Fomatis, Morlul, Skarmory, Poliwag, Sandgast. There we go, is that? And it's the full art version because it has the texture on it. So Espeon GX card. That is sick. That is sick. So put 10 damage counters on your opponent's Pokemon in any way you like. And the GX attacks you can only use once per game. But that's a pretty good one. With Psybeam, your opponent's active Pokemon is now confused. And this attack does 30 more damage times the number of... times the amount of energy attached to the opponent's active Pokemon. So 60 plus 30 for the amount of energy attached to the opponent's Pokemon. And going back to Eevee, you can use Eevee's ability to go find this card and evolve it into this. That's awesome. Then we have Reverse Grimer and a Metal Energy. So that's awesome. I apologize if my voice is kind of raspy. I kind of just woke up and my voice is not cooperating today. But that's awesome. So we have a regular GX, a full art GX, holo, and 2 reverse rares with 1 pack to go. Let's go. Come on. One last good card. If we can get a holo, I'll be completely happy. Two GX cards. I can't ask for more. So let's go for a holo here. I forgot all about Corsola. Such a cute Pokemon. Double colorless energy. Dragonair. Rowlet. Drowsy walking on the beach. Walking on the beach. Doo 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 doo. Cutifly. Makuhita. Snubbull. Reverse Spinder. And that big crab looking thing for our last card with a grass energy. Okay, not that bad of a start. Because we have two reverse rares. We have Crabo, Bruxish, which is still a really ugly Pokemon. A holo Arcanine, which is great. Arcanine's such a boss. I love Arcanine. Then we have Lurantis GX, regular GX. And then also an Espeon Full Art. That's awesome. Great box. Finally, I can get a decent box, and I'm so known for getting all dud boxes. So to open up an Elite Trainer and get two Ultra Rares, a Holo, and a few Reverse Rares was great. I really enjoyed it. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please drop it a like. Comment any suggestions you have for me down below. Subscribe for more content, and I'll see you guys in the next video.